Hello guys, I'm Marut Tiwari. I welcome you to Unacademy Studios Bridge. Like me, there are a pool of excellent educators associated with Unacademy who are helping you effortlessly, who are helping you with, you know, so much effort in your GATE preparation and in your ESC preparation with this channel Studios Bridge. So let me tell you about myself quickly. I'm Marut Tiwari. I did my master's from IIT Kharagpur and I have cracked GATE multiple times. I'm also the author of the book GATE in 75 Days, which is one of the best sellers. And please follow me on Unacademy. Please follow me at this particular link. Please follow me at this particular link, marutlife-4661 to, you know, subscribe and to follow and to learn all my courses. As far as this session is concerned, I'm going to cover the GATE questions that have been asked from slope and deflection topic. You know, slope and deflection is an important topic and is a big topic also. Therefore, I'm going to cover slope and deflection in three parts. In this session, I'm going to cover the slope and deflection problems based on cantilever and those problems which belong to one mark. In the next session, I'll be solving slope and deflection problems belonging to cantilever and the problems that they have asked for 2 marks. And in the third session and the final session of slope and deflection series, I'll be solving problems based on simply supported and overhanging beams. So like me on Unacademy Plus, there are a number of educators. And my dear friends, you can experience Plus for free. You can experience number of courses for free through special classes. And if you're going to prepare for GATE through Unacademy, then there are so many advantages that you get. For example, you can have flexible schedule. You can have language of your choice. You can learn in English. You can learn in Hindi. And you can do unlimited practice. You can watch as many times as you want. And guys, while attending to the live sessions, you can chat with the educators and you can ask your doubts in real time and you can get the real time response. And you can participate in interactive polls and you can learn anytime and anywhere. Particularly to my South Indian friends, I'm telling this that all 5 courses I'm going to teach not only in Hindi but also separately in English. All 5 subjects, engineering mechanics, mechanics of solids, in theory of machines, in machine design, and fluid mechanics, all these 5 subjects I'm going to take not only in Hindi but also in English. So feel comfortable and feel free to subscribe because I'm going to take the guarantee of these 5 subjects. These 5 subjects I'm going to cover systematically, step by step, and extensively. Like I'm going to solve. On Unacademy, I teach live and I'm going to teach live these 5 subjects. Engineering mechanics, strength of materials, and theory of machines, and machine design, and fluid mechanics. And I'm going to take a guarantee of these 40 to 45 marks. So guys, as I said, there are multiple advantages. One such advantage is the reasonable price. If you subscribe, for example, a 12-month package, then you are going to pay just 25,000 rupees. In fact, if you use my code MTLIVE, then you get 10% additional discount. And after getting 10% additional discount, you get to pay just 22,500 rupees. Similarly, you can go for a 24-month package. And if you go for a 24-month package, then it's going to cost you 40,000. But if you use my code MTLIVE, then you get 10% additional discount and you get to pay just 36,000 rupees. 36,000 divided by 24 is only 1500 rupees per month effectively. So guys, this is something very cost effective and this is something value for money. I would recommend you that if you are preparing for GATE 2021, then there is no better way and there is no, you know, easier way to learn and to prepare for your GATE 2021 paper than Unacademy. Unacademy is the best possible platform today Why? If you ask me why, then my answer is not flexible schedule. My answer is not the convenient language choice. My answer is not, you know, the cost effectiveness. My answer is that Unacademy provides you, the student, the choice of selecting the educator. One subject is available from number of educators, and it is you who can decide that, okay, I'm going to take mechanics of solids from this faculty, and I'm going to learn fluid mechanics. Okay, fluid mechanics is being taught by Mr. A also, and fluid mechanics is being taught by Mr. B also, and Mr. C also. So I'm going to decide, I'll attend one session of Mr. A also, I'll attend one session of Mr. B also, and Mr. C also, and I'm going to decide that which educator I'm going to follow. So this is something beautiful. You think about it, this is nowhere available. This is available nowhere. All you need to do is, you need to install an Unacademy Learning app. You need to install an Unacademy Learning app. Just install the Unacademy Learning app. And then choose GATE as your goal. And after selecting GATE as your goal, you'll have various options. As I already detailed, you'll have 12 months package available at 25,000 rupees. And you'll have 24 months package available at 40,000 rupees. Just make sure that before you subscribe, use the code MTLIVE to get 10% additional discount. Now let us start discussing about our topic. Our topic today is slope and deflection. And in slope and deflection, my dear friends, I would recommend you to watch first three videos of this playlist as far as slope and deflection is concerned. I would recommend you to watch first three videos of this playlist where I have described and I have told you about all the tricks and all the shortcuts and all the formulas that are useful for cantilever beams. But I'll tell you quickly even here, just in case if you have not watched those videos, that as far as cantilever beams are concerned, you need to remember these four standard cases. The first standard case is cantilever with a couple. The second standard case is cantilever with a point load. The third standard case is the cantilever with a UDL. And the fourth standard case is the cantilever with a uniformly varying load. The cantilever with a uniformly varying load. And my dear friends, for all these four beams, you please memorize the maximum deflection results and please memorize the maximum slope results. The maximum slope and the maximum deflection results. Please memorize them. The results are maximum slope is ML by EI and maximum deflection is ML squared divided by 2EI as far as first beam is concerned. As far as the second standard beam is concerned, maximum slope is WL squared divided by 2EI and the maximum deflection is WL cube divided by 3EI. As far as the third standard beam is concerned, the maximum slope is given as omega L cube divided by 6EI and the maximum deflection is given as omega L raised to 4 divided by 8EI. And finally, the fourth beam, for a cantilever with UVL, the maximum slope is given as omega naught L cube divided by 24EI and the maximum deflection is given as omega naught L raised to 4 divided by 30EI. My humble request to you is to memorize, is to mug up these eight formulas, and if you want to know the trick to produce these formulas in a matter of 20 seconds, then you please watch my video, my first video that is there in the playlist, Mechanics of Solids for GATE 2020 by Marut Tiwari. So just watch the first video and then if you come back here, you will enjoy this video even more. Apart from remembering these four standard results, apart from remembering these four standard results, my dear friends, you got to remember one more thing. And that one more thing is what? That one more thing is that suppose you have a cantilever beam, and suppose on that cantilever beam you are applying a load W somewhere at the mid, somewhere here at point S. And suppose that S to Q length is B. So consider that on that B length between Q and S, there is nothing available. Now, if this is the case, then the beam is going to deflect in a special way. Between P and S, the beam is going to have curvature. But between S and Q, between S and Q, the beam doesn't have any curvature. Why the beam won't have any curvature? Because my dear friends, between S and Q, there is nothing available. And if there is nothing available, if there is no bending moment, then why bending will occur? And if there is no bending is going to occur, then this SQ length will remain straight. Then this SQ length will remain straight. And if this SQ length will remain straight, then we have something good happening here. Then we can write YQ value. If this SQ length will remain straight, then we can write YQ value as, please be very attentive and try understanding, okay? We can write YQ value as YS plus, you think about this and you'll realize that YQ value you can write as YS plus H. YQ value you can write as YS plus H. And now in this triangle, you can see in this triangle that I'm shading right now, in this particular triangle that I'm shading right now, in this triangle, you can write H is equal to B tan theta S. Now this is theta S. So you can write in that triangle, you can write H divided by B is equal to tan theta S. For very small values of theta, tan theta can be written as simply theta. So now from here, H is equal to B theta S. Now if we replace this H is equal to B theta S, then YQ we can write as YS plus B theta S, isn't it? So this is what you can write. And what about theta Q? What about theta Q? Theta Q is gonna be equal to theta S. Theta Q is gonna be equal to theta S. Why? Because SQ segment is remaining straight. And if SQ segment is remaining straight, then for SQ segment, slope will be constant. So if SQ segment remains straight, then for SQ segment, the slope will be constant. And we can write theta Q is equal to theta S. So that means the deflection and the slope at Q can be expressed. The deflection and the slope at Q can be expressed in terms of the slope and the deflection at S. Now your question will be that how do we find out the deflection and slope at S? To find out the deflection and slope at S, you need to focus on only this much beam. If you focus on this much beam, once again it looks like a standard beam. If you focus on this much beam, my dear friends, once again it looks like a standard beam, and you can use the formula of standard beam on that much beam. You can use the formula of this standard beam on this much length of the beam. So please just remember this screen, this entire screen you'll have to remember. First thing, these eight formulas, and then you'll have to remember this little trick that I described just now. Now let us go ahead and try solving some one mark problems. This 2006 problem, they asked for one mark where we have two cantilever beams. Let's say this is cantilever beam number one and this is cantilever beam number two. And this cantilever beam number one and cantilever beam number two, they are connected at their free ends. At their free ends, they are connected with the help of a roller. with the help of a roller, they are being kept over each other, something like this. So if they are being kept over each other, they are asking that at the free end, because of this load P here, at the free ends, are you going to have equal deflection but unequal slopes? Are you going to have equal slopes but unequal deflections? Are you going to have equal slopes and also equal deflections? Or maybe slopes and deflections both will be unequal. So what is the correct option? You have to tell this. Now in this particular formula, you don't have to use any, formula. In this problem, there's no formula needed. Common sense is needed. You tell me that if you are connecting two things, if you're connecting two things with the help of a roller or a hinge, you tell me that rotation is allowed or not. About a hinge or a roller, something can rotate or not. Obviously, if you are supporting something on a roller or on a hinge, then it can rotate. On a fixed support, rotation is not allowed. On a fixed support, rotation is not allowed. But at a hinge, rotation is allowed. At a roller, rotation is allowed. And if the rotation is allowed, then my dear friends, these two beams are going to deflect together. Why? Because they are connected, so they are going to deflect together. This cantilever beam number one and then this cantilever beam number two, they are going to deflect together. Now you will obviously you will think that the roller will go out, connection will be lost. Sir, let me tell you that deflections are never going to be this much. Deflections are going to be negligibly small. They are going to be of the order of millimeters or even sometimes a fraction of a millimeter. So for the real practical beams, deflections are usually very, 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 very small. And therefore, this much of deflection is not going to take place. Very little deflection will take place, and because they are connected, they will deflect together. But because rotation is allowed, this theta, the slope of the second beam, and this theta, the slope of the first beam, may not be equal. Because about a hinge, I've been telling this to you repeatedly, that about a hinge, rotation is always going to be allowed. About a hinge, rotation is always going to be allowed. So guys, theta 1 and theta 2 are not necessarily equal, but deflections are surely going to be equal. So equal deflections, but not equal slopes. You get the first option as the correct one. Now this is the second problem that we have. This is a 1 mark problem they asked in 2012. The problem says that we have a cantilever beam, and that cantilever beam is subjected to a moment M at the free end. The moment M at the free end, we have a cantilever beam, and that cantilever beam is subjected to moment M at the free end. And we got to calculate the magnitude of maximum deflection. Now, is this a problem? No. This is just a formula they are asking. Cantilever with a couple. Now, for cantilever with a couple, I told you just now, ML square divided by 2EI. ML square divided by 2EI. So you can go for that. ML square divided by 2EI is nothing but the first option. This was as simple as that. Now let us try solving this 1 mark problem that they asked in 2016. This is a cantilever beam having an end load. This is a cantilever beam and having a square cross section of side A, and it is subjected to an end load. Let me draw the beam first of all. That we have a cantilever beam of square cross section we have a cantilever of a square cross section. So this is A and this is A, and it is subjected to an end load. Now what is going to be the maximum deflection, because they are asking about tip deflection. They are asking about tip deflection. So you tell me, what is the tip deflection formula for this one? It's very easy. It's very easy. I told you repeatedly that please do remember these formulas. Cantilever beam with a point load, the maximum deflection formula is WL cube divided by 3EI. Cantilever with a point load, the maximum deflection value is WL cube divided by 3EI. And I value for a rectangle is nothing but BD cube by 12, BD cube by 12. If it is a square, then B and D both are A and A. So you will get finally the tip deflection as what? You will get finally the tip deflection as 4WL cube divided by E A raised to 4. And this is gonna be, if they are focusing only at A, that if A is increased by 19%, then other things are obviously remaining fixed. So let's replace other things by K. Now they are asking that if A is increased by 19%, then Y will be increased or decreased by what percentage? So guys, A is increased. That means you have two scenarios. In one scenario, you have the side value A. In the second scenario, you have the side value A plus 19% increase. A plus 19% increase. So in the second scenario, you have, the side value 1.19A. So now the slope, now the deflection will be what? In the first scenario, the deflection will be K divided by A raised to 4. In the second scenario, the deflection will be, when A is being increased, then the deflection will be what? Then the deflection will be 1.19. The deflection will be 1.19 power 4 and of course A power 4. Now they are asking that what is the tip deflection change? What is the percentage change in the tip deflection value? So it is changing from Y1 to Y2 and you have to calculate the percentage change. How do you calculate the percentage change? Percentage change you calculate as Y2 minus Y1 divided by Y1 and multiplied by 100. So now you know the Y2 value, you know the Y1 value, and you know the Y1 value. So you can put them here. K divided by 1.19 and A raised to 4. This is Y2 minus Y1 value. K divided by A raised to 4. And once again you have K divided by A raised to 4. Now K divided by A raised to 4 is a common factor. So that K divided by A raised to 4 is going to get cancelled. K divided by A raised to 4 is going to get cancelled. Remaining thing if you solve, you will get. My dear friends, you will get this percentage change to be 50.1%. So nearest answer is 50%. Go for it. Now let us try solving. And by the way, you'll get minus sign. You'll get minus sign here if you solve this. What about this one? This 2019 problem that they asked for 1 mark. This is a cantilever beam subjected to UVL and they are asking maximum deflection. This is a cantilever beam subjected to uniformly varying load and they are asking maximum deflection. Let us go back and check the table. table. Here it is. The cantilever beam with UVL is having maximum deflection omega L raised to 4 divided by 30 EI. Omega L raised to 4 divided by 30 EI. So just check for the correct formula. That's it. Omega L raised to 4 divided by 30 EI. That's it. I told you that these standard results are going to help you, and they are going to help you a lot. Guys, I say this once again to you, that if you have not already completed the first three videos that I covered for slope and deflection, then first go back and cover them, and then once again you come back and watch it, then these problems are going to be like child's play for you. So this was all about one mark problems. In the next session, I'm going to solve propped cantilever beams where you have a fixed support at one end, a roller support at another end. I'm going to solve problems where you have frame, where you have not an obvious cantilever, but you have cantilevered frames. And I'm going to solve the problems where the cross-sectional area will be changing. And I'm going to solve the problems where multiple loads will be present. All these are 2 marks problems asked in previous GATE papers. Then I'm going to solve once again the problems based on frames. This is once again a problem based on frame. So how do you solve problems based on frames? That we'll know. And by the way, there is no elaborate big method that you have to follow. We can solve problems based on frame just like that. So just if you want to understand the tricks to solve problems based on cantilevered frames, then watch, don't forget to watch my next session. Then again, a problem based on frame, and here you have the load acting at the midpoint, and then my dear friends, once again you have a propped cantilever. So we have number of 2 marks problems that we are going to solve in the next session. In the next session, we are going to solve number of problems. Just subscribe for this particular channel, Unacademy Studios Bridge, so that we can keep helping you in your GATE preparation. And particularly those of my friends who are preparing for GATE 2021, make sure that you subscribe using my code MTLIVE, because my dear friends, believe me, there is nothing better and there is nothing simpler than Unacademy to prepare for your GATE 2021. Because my dear friends, I'm myself taking a guarantee of 5 subjects: engineering mechanics, mechanics of solids, theory of machines, machine design, and fluid mechanics. I'm gonna cover them in an extensive and in an elaborate way, systematically covering each and every topic, conceptually clearing each and everything. All right, so just make sure that you subscribe for the things. This is the best possible way to learn for GATE and to prepare for GATE 2021. Just in case if you have any doubt, if you have any query, then in the description of the video, a query form is given. You can fill that form, and if you fill that form, I'm going to talk to you. If you fill that form, then that means you have some doubt or something. So you can fill that form and I'm going to talk to you, and I'm going to resolve all your doubts. If you have any doubt, any query related to GATE, related to ESE, related to PSUs, just fill that form and I'm going to resolve your query. Thank you very much for watching the session.